higher than expected factory gate inflation and lower than expected retail sales data from the US and the US yields, and the US dollar higher and equities lower yesterday. So the Fed does now fear a more hawkish tone at next week's FOMC meeting and maybe some fewer rate cuts on the dot plot as well. So welcome. This is Swissquote's daily market talk. So yes, yesterday's mix of economic data from the US, which pointed at higher than expected inflation and lower than expected retail sales data, well, finally broke the Federal Reserve dose and the market, the equity market, pulls back for at least a day. So yes, producer price inflation in the US jumped to 0.6% on a monthly basis in February and to 1.6% on a yearly basis. Higher fuel and food prices were apparently to blame. But even taking the highly volatile energy and food prices out of the metric, well, the core inflation showed higher than expected price pressures last month, because core PPI remained steady at the 2% level. Retail sales, on the other hand, improved less than expected. So altogether, yesterday's economic data forced the market to reconsider the Fed expectations. The probability of a June rate cut from the Fed fell to 60%. The 2-year yield jumped to 4.70%. The US 10-year yield spiked to 4.30%. The US dollar index sharply rose as well, and equities fell, although losses reversed toward the end of the session yesterday, and the S&P 500 closed yesterday's trading session only 0.29% lower, and Nasdaq fell only 0.30%. Now all eyes are on next week's FOMC meeting, of course, where the Fed will update its dot plot, having seen a 2-month jump in inflation numbers, robust jobs data, a relatively strong GDP print, and a quite healthy corporate earnings. So there is a chance that we see the median forecast show no more than 2 interest rate cuts penciled in by the Fed members for this year instead of 3 plotted at the December's dot plot, remember. So we will be walking into next week's FOMC meeting with a hawkish tilt, knowing that it is actually always better for the Federal Reserve not to act too quickly than to act and, well, to be forced to make a U-turn on the way. That would be like the worst case scenario. And now that we are talking about higher inflation due to higher energy prices, note as well that the US crude advanced to $81 per barrel level yesterday after Ukraine damaged 12% of Russia's refining capacity with drone attacks. The IEA also came up and gave support to the oil bulls yesterday by saying that they now anticipate a supply deficit throughout this year if OPEC Plus continues to cut output in the second quarter, which is happening. So this is a significant change in IEA's forecast, mind you, as they were actually pointing at a surplus at their earlier prediction. So price-wise, trend and momentum indicators support a further rise in oil prices, but I still see strong resistance near the $82 per barrel level and think that the oil bulls could actually hit a wall at this level, especially if we see a hawkish shift from the Federal Reserve at next week's monetary policy meeting. So this is where we are right now in the FX markets. The euro dollar tumbled to 108.73 yesterday on the back of a broadly stronger US dollar and rising speculation that, well, the European Central Bank will cut its interest rates, even if it's not fully sure that inflation in the eurozone is headed toward its 2% target. So this is what the Belgian Central Bank head Pierre Wunsch said earlier this week, remember? And yesterday, well, the governor of the Bank of Greece went a step further than that, and he said that, well, the European Central Bank should cut its interest rates twice before its August break. But I will tell you one thing, they could hardly act alone and make as many as rate cuts that they want, because the European Central Bank, as every other central bank on the face of this earth, is concerned with what the US Federal Reserve does. Because if the Fed turns hawkish, and if the US dollar appreciates as a result of this hawkishness, while the rest of the world will suffer the return of inflation to their countries as well, because, well, everything is negotiated in terms of US dollars on, well, the international market. So unless Europeans accept to buy Russian oil and Russian rubles, well, there is little chance that we see the European Central Bank go crazy and cut its interest rates twice before their summer break, if the Fed refrains from cutting its rates on its end. So let's calm down, I would say, and let's wait a little bit what happens. But on the euro front, I was bearish on the euro dollar since the start of this year, and I still am, as the eurozone's morose economic outlook does call for more action from the European Central Bank. So yes, I am actually relieved to see the euro dollar take a more understandable direction this week. The pair will step into a medium-term bearish consolidation zone if it slips below the 108.67 level, which is the major 38.2% Fibonacci retracement on February to March rebound, and could extend losses all the way down to 106 level in the continuation of an ABCD pattern. Elsewhere, the dollar yen is trending higher despite news that the wages negotiations in Japan show that big Japanese corporations meet the wages demand, and that could obviously help the Bank of Japan to finally take that crucial step of exiting the negative rate. So today, Rengo, the country's biggest union group, is due to announce its own numbers. Now, the numbers are not out yet at the time I'm talking here this morning, but today's news actually suggests that, well, the union could strike a pay rise of more than 5%, according to Nomura. So strong wages growth in Japan, as elsewhere, is inflationary and should convince the Bank of Japan to act sooner rather than later. But I think that the BOJ won't act in a hurry next week and will wait the April meeting still, where they will have a clearer view, a clearer picture on the wages situation after the second and the third round of the wages negotiations that are due between end of March and the beginning of April, and that will actually not only take the wage negotiations at the major Japanese corporations into account, but those at medium and small size Japanese companies as well. But this being said, well, given the positive news that we see on the wire from the early negotiations, it is still very interesting to me to see that the Japanese yen bulls, well, don't hold a dominant position in the market this week, because the dollar yen is back trading above the 148 level this morning. A broadly stronger US dollar certainly explains the major part of why the dollar yen couldn't gain enough further downside momentum this week, but given how cheap the Japanese yen has become over the past year, well, I would have expected the yen bulls to resist to the dollar's upside pressure a little bit better, but they have not. Still, I still think that going short the Japanese yen at the current levels, well, doesn't offer enough potential of gain, because it's not worth taking the risk of a sizable bullish run that we might see in the Japanese yen into next week's Bank of Japan decision. And while speaking of all these central bank decisions, the People's Bank of China left its MLF rate unchanged today, while home prices fell for the 13th month in China, warning that all the efforts that are deployed by the Chinese government so far to stop bleeding in the country's problematic property sector, well, have been in vain. So this is all for this week. I'm İpek Özkardeşkaya, and thank you for joining me, and thank you for all your supportive and beautiful messages. I hope this episode of Market Talk has been helpful and it has been insightful to you. So please do not hesitate to leave your comments, your reactions, and your questions below as usual. Follow us on Instagram, on X, and on LinkedIn for regular market updates. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for daily market comments. And please do not forget to hit the like button on these videos to let us know that you enjoy them. So I will meet you again next week. And until then, good day trading and have a lovely weekend.